In other news, Iran warned that it will be beginning enriching uranium to 60% purity, the highest level yet, but still short of weapons grade. The announcement follows an attack that damaged the Natanz nuclear facility, an attack that Tehran blames on Israel. The Iranian foreign minister insisted today that his government won't be deterred.
I assure you that Natanz will definitely, in the near future, progress with more advanced centrifuges. And if Israel thought they can prevent Iran and the Iranian people from pursuing the lifting of the U.S. sanctions, they've played a very bad gamble.
The warning came hours before informal talks in Vienna on the U.S. rejoining the Iran nuclear accord. The holy month of Ramadan began today in much of the Muslim world amid surging COVID cases and restrictions. In Saudi Arabia, limited numbers of worshipers were allowed inside the Grand Mosque in Mecca for a socially distanced walk around the Kaaba shrine. Egypt banned some traditional events, while Indonesia opened mosques under strict protocols. Back in this country, a slain U.S. Capitol Police officer, William Billy Evans, was honored by the nation's leaders. The 18-year-old veteran died this month when a man rammed his car into him and another officer outside the Capitol. Today, family members, fellow officers, lawmakers, and President Biden gathered in the Capitol Rotunda. The president spoke directly to Evans' widow and two young children.
You're going to make it. By holding each other together, most importantly, by holding Logan and Abigail as tightly as you can. Because as long as you have them, you've got Billy. As long as you have them.
Following the ceremony, Evans lay in honor for the remainder of the afternoon. There are new appeals tonight for the United States to cut greenhouse gas emissions. More than 300 businesses, including Apple, Google, and Coca-Cola, are urging reductions of 50% from 2005 levels by the year 2030. Dozens of European lawmakers, executives, and union leaders made a similar appeal today. President Biden is nominating the first person of color to lead the U.S. Census Bureau. Robert Santos is Mexican-American and currently runs the American Statistical Association. The Census Bureau is now working on data from the 2020 count that will be used in redrawing congressional districts. And on Wall Street, tech stocks were up, but other sectors fell. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 68 points to close at 33,677. The NASDAQ rose 146 points. The S&P 500 added 13 for another new record close. Still to come on the NewsHour, tensions rise as Russia mobilizes troops along its border with Ukraine. A small Florida community works toward energy independence with a massive array of solar panels. A new biography underlines the influence of former First Lady Nancy Reagan, plus much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.